the Inner Harbor at Oriole Park here in Baltimore. Tonight, it's an AL Eastern Division matchup between the Boston Red Sox and the Baltimore Orioles.
And now, your 2021.
We've got baseball on the
Baltimore
show, and it's
Orioles.
Coming up next. Now to the plate, here is Kike Hernandez, and we are set for baseball here this evening. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. 77 degrees our temperature at game time tonight. Look out, that one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
You know, we'll see him work both sides of the plate with his curveball. Maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around the zone to give it a different look.
So he punches him out looking at the fastball. Kike Hernandez is retired to lead off the ball game. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball. Pitches away, but it's swung on and grounded to second. He's got it. And there's out number two. Next up for the Red Sox, Xander Bogaerts. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. The 2-1.
Yeah, this is one of my biggest pet peeves in the game when guys get count leverage and take fastballs. It's a game of fastballs. You calibrate everything off the heater. Surprising take right there.
Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Now to the plate, Cedric Mullins. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A swing, and this one is blasted to right field. Nothing's gonna stop it. Into the flag court and gone. Standing in now, Ryan Mountcastle. Oh, they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Boy, that's a jam shot right there. That's as good as it gets, in my opinion. Up and in.
2-2 the count. Into the windup and the pitch. Fouled away. Bases are empty here. Nobody out. A full count to the Orioles designated hitter. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out. Ready now for Baltimore, Anthony Santander, as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box.
And this isn't his strong side, at least not in terms when you look at the stat sheet or his consistent contact rates. I just don't think he's quite as smooth with his rhythm and swing mechanics when he's hitting left-handed.
Just hung in there on that one. Lifted the other way out to left center. Schwarber is under this one, and he's got it for out number two. In now for the O's, Trey Mancini, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive.
Mancini.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Second inning set to go, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Rafael Devers. Ground ball right side, straight into the shift. On to first, and there's one gone here to start the second. So bases are empty with one gone, and that'll bring up the dangerous bat of J.D. Martinez. Orioles out to an early 1-0 lead here in inning number two. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Mullins is there. Two gone. Base is empty. Two away. And that brings up the outfielder, Alex Verdugo. Two out, nobody on.
At
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
After watching that one go by and a ball being called, you could rest assured he knows he's not getting away with another one of those. I guarantee you he's going to be aggressive on this next pitch.
A bouncer up the middle. And the Red Sox have their first hit of the ball game. To the plate now, Hunter Renfroe. And he'll lay off the fastball down low. It's 2-1 now. Three and one.
When a pitcher puts you in the proverbial rocking chair like he's doing right now, you have to take a deep breath. You can't start trying to guess along with him. Trust your fundamentals and stay on that fastball.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Liner in there for a base hit. So now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
The first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
At the plate now, Bobby Dalbec. 2-1 to the Red Sox first baseman.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Into center field, line drive, base hit. And the run will come in to score from third as that'll knock things up at one apiece. Into the box, Christian Vasquez. Bouncer to the left side. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. Austin Hayes the next to bat. Mano y mano against Nady Evaldi, batting 500, 4-for-8. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. At the plate now is Pedro Severino. First chance for him here with a man on following the leadoff walk. The 1-1 is strike two swinging. And it's fouled away. Hayes aboard here at first with nobody out. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. 2-2.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Pedro Severino is dealt with for the first out in the bottom of the inning. Now a throw over, a dive, but he's back. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Ooh, wee, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Batting it.
So now into the box is number one. This will be his first trip to the plate in this one. Throw over to the bag, and the runner back safely. Now a little soft liner foul over to the right side, and the count will move to 1-2 now. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Top of the third set to get underway, and that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Kike Hernandez. Here comes the 1-2.
Don't be shocked if he doesn't go right back to that same pitch. You could tell he jelly-legged him at the plate a little bit, froze him, but just missed his zone.
Still 2-2.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well three times in a row with off speed.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Kyle Schwarber.
keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Lake making contact on that swing and will do it again on 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
Now batting.
Striding in for Boston, Xander Bogaerts, trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. 1-2 to the Boston shortstop. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Mullins finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Stepping up is Kelvin Gutierrez as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Now the 2-1 pitch.
One thing that can nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at bat here.
Renfro moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one. Back to the top of the Oriole lineup now, and stepping in, Cedric Mullins. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first appearance in this one.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
Hey, three foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put-away stuff.
And he'll get to see another one. It'll be the 10th pitch of this at-bat. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. And gone. An absolute bomb. Into the box now, Ryan Mountcastle. Fouled off. Bases are empty, one man out. And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two.
The batter, the right
next
fielder.
To dig in, Anthony Santander flew out last time up. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Now batting.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Trey Mancini, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there.
And the center fielder is under it to make the catch, and the inning is over. All set for the start of the fourth, and digging in is the big time power threat, Rafael Devers. Down low, two balls and a strike. Two and two now.
This guy's been throwing the ball great so far, but he's going to be tested here. 4, 5, and 6 coming up this part of the lineup.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 2-2 one more time. Now he turns on a fastball and sends it deep down the right field line. And that is off the wall. He'll get it into second, and he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. Christian Arroyo will have to get loose in a hurry now as he'll come in and run following the injury. So now to the plate, J.D. Martinez. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Sent in the air out to straightaway central. Mullins is there, and he has it for the first out. Next to hit is Alex Verdugo. The base knocked to the outfield could score the tying run from second. The 3-1. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. The 1-1 pitch. Went up and out of the zone that time, but he gets a piece of it, and he'll see another pitch.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. 3 foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
Even 2-2 count to Hunter Renfro. Base hit into right center. The throw to the plate. But this won't be in time as he's well safe and the run scores.
Now batting, the first baseman, Bobby Dalbec.
Stepping in now, Bobby Dalbec, driven to deep right field. Santander on the run. On the warning track, he makes the catch. And the go-ahead runs in to score as they break the tie. It's 3-2. Two down with a runner at first. And from the on-deck circle into the batter's box comes Christian Vasquez. Two balls and a strike. Renfro leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. All even now, 2-2. From the belt, kicks and deals.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
The 3-2 pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Santander waits on it. And that ends the inning. And now, Austin Hayes worked a walk his first time up. Now the 1-1 pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Schwarber will wait on it. And he puts it away for the first down. Pedro Severino digs in at the plate. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. The 1-1 home.
Well, that's off the plate.
Pat Valaika will be next. The 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Hey, that's the modern game right now. North-south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east-west we came up playing.
And another foul ball. We're in the fourth. 3-2 is our score. Swing, and he launches this one to deep left field. Looking up is the left fielder. Gone! In now, Pat Valaika. And he fouls this one off. One out, nobody on. still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
Number one will be next. Swung on in the dirt, strike three. And he makes the throw to first. Valaika is retired, two down now.
The batter.
Up next, number one comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. The 2-2.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And that finds its way through for a base hit.
The third baseman, number 13, Kelvin Gutierrez.
At the plate now, Kelvin Gutierrez. Strike called, now the throw down. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. He struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. So the Red Sox lineup turns over, and to the plate, Kike Hernandez. The 1-1.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down and away, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Trying to strike him out for the third time.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning. Kyle Schwarber will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher, as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Got him on the good slider there, swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Next to stand in is Xander Bogaerts. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Now batting.
And that'll bring up the former first-rounder, Christian Arroyo. First at-bat of the game for him here in the fifth, as he was a late entrant into this one. One ball and two strikes to count. Now a fastball taken outside here as it moves it to 2-2 now. Hit in the air down the right field line. On the run is Santander. A dive, and he brings it in. And on a fantastic play, the inning is over. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and digging in is the outfielder, Cedric Mullins.
To show you how strong this guy is, he hit that last off-speed pitch over 400 feet, so the pitcher wasn't supplying most of the power there. This is a really strong hitter.
And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Designated hitter, Ryan Mountcastle.
The 1-1 is laid off for ball two.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at bat trying to get ahead and put himself at a good hitter's count.
Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2. Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Anthony Santander the next to bat. It was a walk in his last trip. 1-1. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. Around first, digging for two. The throw is wild, and it gets away.
Now batting, first baseman, Greg Mancini.
At the plate, Trey Mancini. Two balls and a strike to the Orioles' first baseman.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Two balls and two strikes to Mancini now.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. Austin Hayes would be next if they can keep this inning alive. And there's a base hit on the line. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Into the box now, J.D. Martinez. 3-1 to Martinez. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. He's set, and the payoff pitch. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. Now at the plate, Alex Verdugo. Hit the target, but this is low. 2-1.
2 balls, 1 strike. Count.
Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1. Hunter Renfroe is on deck. Now a drive out to left center field. Running hard, he's digging for second, and he'll pull into second with one away.
The white fielder, number 10.
So now to the plate, Hunter Renfroe fouled away. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. That'll bring up Bobby Dalbec. A couple of RBIs for him already, and a chance for more here. 2-1.
This right-handed pitcher, his bread and butter is that two-seamer, and he loves to throw it inside.
3-1. Christian Vasquez would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Ready with the 3-1. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now. 3-2.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him.
Bullet to second base, a fine play, and that ends the inning. Garrett Richards enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. Ready now is Austin Hayes. He's 0-1 thus far. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Here's another 1-2. And it's fouled away. Hit on the ground is short. And there's one away. Now to bat, Pedro Severino. 1-2 in the ball game thus far.
Severino.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now here's the pitch. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Now batter.
That'll bring in the versatile Pat Valaika. He was sat down on strikes in his last at bat. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
The 2-2. Both teams with six hits so far. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And he gets there, makes the running play, and that ends the inning. So now to the plate, Christian Vasquez. He flew out in his last AB. And that one yanked just foul. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. Back to him on the mound. Back up the, oh no, that got him. And they are able to get the out at first, but more importantly, let's hope he's okay on the mound. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Kike Hernandez. It was a walk in his last trip. The 2-1. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. Next, here is Kyle Schwarber. He went down on strikes last time up. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, this is a huge at bat right here. This pitcher wants to end this inning and have 3, 4, 5 due up to start the next inning.
To two balls and two strikes now. Hit hard up the middle, right to him. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over.
Time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
So here is number one, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. To 2-2 now.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and you swing at a pitch that bad? Not good.
Hit out towards second. Scooped up. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. And now here is Kelvin Gutierrez. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Bogaerts calls for it, makes the play, and there are two gone now. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Cedric Mullins. He grounded out last time up. The 1-1. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. Reined in. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring up the shortstop and one of the better two-strike hitters in baseball, Xander Bogaerts. The 1-1 misses, ball two. Fastball is looked at for strike two. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
Action pitch right here, 2-2. The last thing you want to do is to fall behind the count 3-2.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Xander Bogaerts goes quietly to lead off the eighth. Throw in time at first for out number two. To the plate now is the designated hitter, J.D. Martinez. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike three. Striding forward now is the DH, Ryan Mountcastle. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat. The 1-1. Fouled off. Richards gets the sign. I'll try to put him away here on 2-2. Hit back up the middle. And that'll get through into center. So there's your possible go-ahead run on base now to lead off the inning.
Now batting, right fielder, Anthony.
Stepping in now, Anthony Santander. A ball and two strikes. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey.
Gone!
And that two-run home run delivers an eighth-inning lead. To the plate now, Trey Mancini. Hit the other way out toward right field. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Now into the box, Austin Hayes grounded out in his last at bat. Five runs, eight hits, and no errors for the Orioles so far. Count still at 1-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. So next to hit is
Pedro Severino.
He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Cole Sulcer comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. All set to start the ninth in this one, and that brings up the outfielder Alex Verdugo.
Looking for base runners here as they're down two playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, three balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Mullins comes on now, and he has it, one down. Stepping in once again is Hunter Renfro. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. The 2-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Swing and a line drive to left. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield.
The batter, the first baseman, Bobby.
Into the box, Bobby Dalbec. Swing and a miss as he was way early on that one. 3-2.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic on a base pass and just attack the zone.
Striding in is Christian Vasquez. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. He's got it. On to first, and that's your ball game.
Hey, this was a pretty tightly played game. Got a little bit of everything in this one. Some timely hitting, runs on the board, key pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
And this evening's contest comes to a close, 5-3 the final. The O's get the win on the heels of four home runs. Number 78 is credited with the win. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Orioles, 5 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base.